Hello, welcome to our first tutorial on angular motion. Here you can see that this is a disk which is rotating along the axis and the torque is being applied by the hands of a person. So you can see all these components are perpendicular to each other, the force, the motion of this disk and the R, the displacement, the volume of torque. This is an example of a wheels which is performing rotational motion. This is an example of a top that is also performing rotational motion. These are the kinematical equations and all these are the linear kinematical equations, and we have total 1, 2, 3 as the kinematical equations, and this is the last example. That's a ballet dancer, how she can balance herself on the floor. So let's begin with our topic. What is meant by angular motion? Now in this you'll find that this middle line is known as axis of rotation, and for the time being we are denoting this line as omega. Omega stands for angular velocity. Now here this is an y-axis, this one is an x-axis. Now here in this case you'll find a point P which is performing a circular motion. From the center of center, that is from the axis of rotation, the distance of this point P is R. So that is just a distance from the axis of rotation, and which is we are denoting it as a R. Okay, now here in this case if you'll find this is a center of a circle, this is an x-axis and this one is the y-axis. Now presently the object was at A, it has moved from A to P. Okay, it has moved from A to P, so the displacement is S. Okay, but in terms of angular displacement, in terms of angle, it is theta. Its distance from the center is denoted as R. Similarly, its distance from the O, it's denoted as R. And here, the it is making an angle theta with the x-axis. So here, if I just want to have a look in a close form, you'll see that this OA from A till P at say time t2, so it will make an angle theta 2. The distance where from O it will be r2. Similarly at time t1, the angle made by the point it will be theta 1, and here the displacement is also again r1. So as a result, if I want to determine the displacement of an object, so I'll denote it as theta is equals to S by R. Here in this case, S is called the arc length and R is the magnitude of position vector of the particle. Okay? And here all these quantities are measured in radians. This theta is equals to S by R. This theta also called as the angular displacement. So angular displacement is equals to S by R. Now here in this part you can see arc performs more familiar with the unit of degree for measuring angles. The unit of radians is related to degree by the following formulas. You can see 360 degrees Celsius is equals to 2 pi radians. So we'll just cut all the values and we'll get pi is equals to 3.14159217. Fine. Now let's go to the next topic, is angular displacement. In the previous page we have learned what is meant by angular displacement. It's just a displacement, it's a motion from this point to this point. We call this thing as angular displacement. So it's denoted by theta. So here in this case, from this, let us consider this as x-axis, this as the y-axis. So here in this part, from here till here, the displacement is denoted as theta 1, and from here to here, that is from this point to this point, we are denoting the displacement as theta 2, and the arc is denoted as s, and the position vector is denoted as r. Okay, the motion can be clockwise, the motion can be anti-clockwise. Fine. So in the sense of idea of rotation is associated with angular motion. So we have both clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation. So let us represent an anti-clockwise rotation of say theta by an radian arrow of a certain length pointing in the certain direction. So then a rotation of minus theta radians will be an arrow of the same length but putting in the opposite direction, but in that direction would be the first arrow point. Now here you will see, just in this case you have to know what the angular displacement is. Same thing, now just see, we have the continuation for the angular displacement, how the displacements are being denoted from here to here. It's denoted as theta 1, and again if you are going back, so it will be like from here to here, it is theta 1. Similarly for this also, it will be from this, starting from here it will go till 1, it will be theta 1, and from 12 it's coming back to 9, so it is theta 2. This is just a clock, how to denote this in radians. So here in this case theta 1, it's 2 pi by 3. This can be denoted as 2 pi by 3. And displacement is a vector quantity. The unit for displacement is radians. Angular velocity, angular acceleration. As we know, the rate of change of displacement with respect to time is velocity. The rate of change of velocity with respect to time is an acceleration. But if you are talking about angular, so we'll have the angular displacement. So here it will be the rate of change of angular displacement with respect to time. So we call this thing as angular velocity, and rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time, we call it as an angular acceleration. So here in this case, we have a definition for the average angular speed for a particle having a displacement delta theta. See here, it should be theta, but they have written 8, so this is a correction which you have to do. So I'm just marking it with the highlighter so that this correction you can do it later on. So they should be theta in time 80. Here it is 80, means they just want to say average. We have done this before. Wherever it will be average, they have written it as A. But instead of A, you can write this delta also. And this is a vector quantity, so that's the reason you have to draw the vector above the omega. So the formula for the angular speed, that is an average angular speed, it is omega is equals to delta theta upon delta t. Now for infinitesimal change, that is if delta theta is very small, then omega will be a vector and it will be in the same direction as delta theta, and we will call this average angular velocity, and then it will be in the limits. So when we are talking about infinitesimal, we have to denote our formula in limits, and that limit will go from delta t tends to 0. So here in this case, if you will see, where is that highlighter? So this delta t tends to 0, this you have to remember. For all other proofs which we are going to learn in our future chapters, wherever we are talking about infinitesimal, so there we have to apply limits, and that limits will be delta t tends to 0. See here in this, you'll find this is delta theta upon delta t. So here again they have written is 80, so this is not A, this is delta. Okay, so here delta theta upon delta t, that is in change in time, which is equals to, in terms of differential form, it is d theta upon dt, not l. ये क्या है? d theta upon dt है. तो ये दूसरा correction है इसमें. ठीक है, I hope you are noting down all the corrections which we are doing it here. Now here, as you will see that for infinitesimal angular velocity, we are having omega is equals to limit of delta t tends to 0. And that is d theta, which is a vector form the infinitesimal angular displacement. Okay, so this term, we can also write it as d theta, and also d theta is equals to d multiply and divide by dt. What is dt? Dt is a change in time. Time is not a vector quantity, it's a scalar quantity. So that is the instantaneous angular velocity omega, it's a vector quantity. So again, here the SI unit for the angular velocity is radian per second. For linear form, we write it as meter per second, but for the angular form, we'll write it as radians per second. And the symbol for the angular velocity is, this is actually a W, like W, but we call it as an omega. The name for this symbol is omega. Okay. Now next, we have to start with what is meant by the angular acceleration. The way we have started with angular velocity, we have to start this angular acceleration. So what is meant by angular acceleration? It is rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. So that is omega 2 minus omega 1 divided by t2 minus t1, or in general we can write it as delta omega upon delta t. Again, here omega is a vector quantity and delta t is a scalar quantity. So as overall, this alpha becomes the vector quantity. The unit for alpha, that is angular acceleration, is equals to radians per second square. It will, in the linear form we call it as meter per second square, but here it will be radians per second square. If you will just view your right hand, you'll find that the axis of rotation, here in this case, just a minute, if you curl your right hand, the thumb will point the direction of angular velocity. Okay, and if you will just invert your right hand, you will get the motion of angular velocity in clockwise, but in a straight wave form you will get it in a anti-clockwise. So the angular velocity, you'll get it in a clockwise, and you'll get the angular velocity in terms of anticlockwise. Okay, so the direction of angular velocity, it is given by the right hand rule. Okay, so I hope this diagram is also clear, how we have used our right hand rule to explain how the angular velocity of an object is. So now again we are at the instantaneous angular acceleration. We had the instantaneous angular velocity. So when, as I told you, when we are using a term instantaneous, we have to apply a limit. That is a small change in delta omega. So here it will be, we have again a correction. So here it is, alpha is equals to limit of delta t tends to 0. Limits we have applied. Delta omega upon, what is here? It is, here you have to write it as delta t. This again a correction, delta t, which is equals to, this will be dw. Again, this one is a correction, and this is a dt. This is dw, and this one is a dw, and the below one is a dt. Fine. So the instantaneous angular acceleration is equals to limit of delta t tends to 0. dw upon dt, or d omega upon dt. Now, what is the direction of angular acceleration in this figure? That is figure 4.5. If the angular velocity changes only in magnitude but not in direction. So what will be? So then omega will simply decrease or it will increase. Just see these diagrams. And we are at the last topic. We are going to compare our kinematical equations. If you remember at the start of this video, I have just shown the kinematical equations in the linear form. We had xav is equals to u square plus 2as, s is equals to ut plus half at square, and v is equals to u plus at. So those all linear kinematical equations, we are going to compare it with the angular quantity. So as a result, this is a comparison between the linear quantity with the angular quantity. So here in this case, you will see the great difference between all these values. In linear form, the position we are denoting as x, but here in angular form we are denoting it as theta. For speed, we used a symbol v, and v we used to write it as dx by dt. But for angular form, we are using a symbol omega. It's similar to w, but which is equals to d theta upon dt. Then for acceleration, rate of change of velocity with respect to time, we were using a symbol dt, dv by dt, which is equals to d square x upon dt square. And similarly here also for angular acceleration, we have used a symbol as alpha. Alpha is equals to dw upon dt, which is equals to d square theta upon dt square. Fine. This is a kinematical equations, how we have written. Here it is, v is equals to 1 upon 2 v naught plus v. V naught stands for the initial velocity plus final velocity. So here in angular form it is omega, which is equals to 1 upon 2 omega naught plus omega. Next, v is equals to u plus at. This is, instead of u, we have used a symbol v naught. V naught stands for initial velocity. And here it is, omega is equals to omega naught plus, instead of a, we are using alpha. And t won't be changing. T is as it is. It is t. Here is it is, v is equals to ut plus half at square. So here, same comparison is, theta is equals to omega naught t plus 1 upon 2 alpha t square. And here v square is equals to u square plus 2as. Here it is, omega square is equals to omega naught square plus 2 alpha theta. So this is just a comparison between the angular and the linear quantities. Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.